The summer was fast approaching, and Dave, unsurprisingly, was complaining again. "I've got too much work to do as it is, sir. I can't be everywhere all at once." "I agree, which is why we have another mixed traffic steam engine arriving next month. She'll be primarily helping you out with your work, so you can actually get a break once in a while." "Oh, that was pretty thoughtful of you actually, sir." "I guess it was, wasn't it? Now, back to work!" For the rest of the month, Dave and the others wondered what kind of engine would arrive. Eustace in 257 hoped for another bullied design, such as a Q1. Raymond thought it likely that a Standard 4 or Standard 5 would be brought in, while Dave hoped another Black 5 would arrive from the north, perhaps one of his long-lost sisters. But when the new locomotive arrived, everybody was shocked, for it was an ex-Great Western Hall class. She introduced herself as Hannah, and appeared to get on well with everybody, quickly joining in with the banter and jokes of the other engines. Dave and Hannah were soon rostered onto shifts, so that while one engine was working, so the other was receiving maintenance and having a rest. Despite being older than Dave, she was certainly capable, being able to match and sometimes exceed his performance. Though he was jealous at first, he quickly came to accept her as an excellent addition to the fleet. One evening, Hannah arrived back to the sheds while Dave and Raymond were in the middle of a discussion. She rolled up alongside. "Think he will be back?" "I don't know. The details are sketchy as it is. We only have you and Brian's word to go by." "But he warned me that some danger was coming, so he must be coming back."
"Sorry, but who's coming back? Is this another with Mr. Dark's engines?"
"No, no, I'm referring to Pogo, the ghost engine I saw last year. It takes the shape of a Fowler goods engine and..."
But ghosts don't exist, Dave. Surely you know that."
Well, this one does. I saw it."
"Oh, grow up. Ghosts can't exist. Especially ghost engines. I mean, come off it. That's insane."
"I'll have you know that Pogo is real. I saw him. My mate Brian saw him too."
"Then this Brian must be deluded as well. Tell me you don't believe a word of this, Raymond."
Raymond considered for a moment.
"Well, if they say they saw a ghost, then I believe them."
"Then you must be deluded as well. There is no such thing as ghosts."
And she stormed away to take her evening train. "Okay, then." The following evening, Hannah arrived at the gaswork to collect her train, when she saw Abomination clearing up the yard. Hannah frowned at him.
"Hello, Abomination. Where's my train?"
"Oh, sorry, Hannah. I'm needed at Mirkoom, so I've just cleared up before going. Your trucks are still at the industrial estate, but you'll have to marshal the train together yourself, I'm afraid."
"Oh, that's no problem. Anyone else around to give me a hand?"
Not that I'm aware of. Everyone else is at Mirkoom. There's a football match on tonight, apparently, so they've begged Mr. Dark to install a television in the shed for them to tune in. You might want to steer clear for tonight."
"Oh, great. I think I will then. Thanks."
At that, Abomination rushed off. Then she realised something.
"That cheeky scrub! He's going to watch the football match too! He could have at least finished his work first."
Dejected, Hannah slowly made her way down to the industrial estate.
"Ah well, at least I don't have to listen to them lot screaming about goals and fouls and whatever else."
As she rolled into the yard, she noted that, despite what Abomination had said, her train was already assembled and ready to go.
How odd. Maybe he forgot he'd already assembled it.
Not thinking much of it, she coupled up and left the yard. The next day, she arrived back at Mirkoom Sheds, having slept at the junction to avoid listening to the football match. Unfortunately, the others were still talking about it. Not really wanting to hear about it, she sought out Abomination, who was mid-conversation with Lino.
"That goal was absolutely perfect. Skimmed the net perfectly."
"I know, right? But aren't you upset? Palzini got a red card right afterwards, and he's your favourite player."
"He shouldn't have kicked the Hargreaves shins then, should he? And anyway... Oh, hello, you. Oh, hi. enjoy your football program, did you?
Well, you see, the thing about that is, it doesn't matter. I only came over to thank you for actually marshalling that train for me.
Huh?
My train. You said you hadn't had time to put it together.
I didn't.
But surely you did. You were the only ever engine down there yesterday.
That's right, but I didn't shunt the train together.
But that's impossible. You must have.
I tell you, I didn't marshal that train. The trucks were everywhere when I left.
Dave, who happened to catch some of the conversation, called over. Hey, Hannah, perhaps it was a ghost that did it.
Fuck off, Dave!
Hannah was still cross when she arrived at the industrial estate that night. Abomination was shunting up at the gasworks, so she had volunteered to bring his trucks up from the yard to avoid being around Dave and possibly causing another row. She sighed as she marshalled her trucks together, trying to think of a logical explanation for the mysterious events of the previous night. But nothing came to her, apart from that Abomination was lying or was being very forgetful. Soon she had a short rake of trucks ready to climb the hill, but she felt uneasy as she stood in the yard. It was a misty night, and it was drizzling. In the distance, she thought she could hear a steam engine. Hannah presumed it was just Abomination working up on the line, but it sounded closer, and seemed to be coming from the yard itself.
Just your imagination, old girl, she said to herself, as she steamed out of the yard.
The rails were slippery due to the drizzling mist, and she slipped slightly as she approached the tunnel. Once inside, however, the incline got the better of her, and about halfway through she stopped, her boiler pressure dropping quickly.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
While she waited for her boiler pressure to rise again, she heard the sounds of a steam engine nearby.
Oh good, Abomination must be coming down. He must have heard me.
But it didn't sound like Abomination. The puffing sounded wheezy, unlike Abomination's geezer ejector, and it sounded like it was coming from the bottom of the tunnel rather than the top. Suddenly, Hannah felt something push her from behind, and she actually felt herself move forward slightly.
Holy shit!
Hannah screamed and, despite having hardly any boiler pressure left, jumped forward and started climbing the tunnel as if her life depended on it. She screeched as she left the tunnel, puffing straight up the line and past the bewildered Abomination, who was waiting at the yard entrance to help her. Hannah didn't stop until she got to Manston 4, where she abandoned her trucks and ran back to Mearcombe Sheds, where Dave was still awake, chatting happily to Ryan.
Oh, hello Hannah. Look, I just wanted to Christ, you look like you've just seen a
ghost!
Yeah.
Something just pushed me in the tunnel.
Cheeky.
Save it for the comedy night at Culhapper MPD. I'm serious. It wasn't any of you lot, and it wasn't Abomination. It sounded like an old engine.
Maybe it was Pogo. Perhaps you're the great danger he told me about. That's why he just attacked you.
What?
Oh, here we go again. But don't you see, Ryan? Perhaps Pogo warned me about Hannah. Are you a spy? Are you secretly working for her?
Who's her?
Leanne! She's still out there plotting her revenge against us. You're working for her, aren't you? Aren't you?
What the hell are you talking about? I don't even know anyone called Leanne.
Suddenly, Abomination puffed in, breaking up the argument.
Hannah, are you alright? The signalman just told me you ran up here looking terrified. Something pushed me in Gasworks Tunnel. It sounded like an old steam engine and I heard something moving around in the industrial estate, and I think it was a ghost. Dave was right. There is a ghost haunting the railway, and I think it's picking on me.
It's Pogo. He sent me a warning last year. I think Hannah might be a spy sent here to destroy us all.
Shut up! I'm not a spy. Abomination, back me up here! Do you know how ridiculous you two sound? Hannah isn't a spy, and there's no such thing as ghosts. Let me show you. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'm not going back down there.
I'm not either. Not with Pogo around.
Grow up, you two. Come on. I'll prove to you that there's no such thing as ghosts, and there's no ghosts down there.
Abomination began to steam away. Dave and Hannah followed, looking terrified. With Abomination leading the way, the three engines rolled down to the industrial estate. Dave and Hannah stayed well back, staying close together, whilst Abomination rolled confidently forward into the mist and called out.
You've been discovered! Come out so I can show these two that you're real!
The sounds of steam echoed around. Dave and Hannah screamed when a small engine emerged from the mist. But Dave suddenly recognised the little Midland engine.
Ed? Dave!
Dave was about to move forward, but jumped again as a second engine rolled forwards. Hannah recoiled in horror, but Dave grinned widely.
Well, fuck me sideways with a shunting pole. Is that you, Sid? Oh, hello, Dave. Long time no see.
Together, Ed and Sid rolled forward, grinning. Hannah looked thoroughly confused, and Dave tried to explain.
You see, Ed and Sid here are old friends of mine, from my days on the Somerset and Dorset Joint Railway. I haven't seen them for years.
I spotted this Ed after you screamed past me, Hannah. He told me he and his friend might have scared you.
Trust me, we didn't mean to. I was only trying to help you up the incline.
So what brings you two here, anyway?
Long story. British Rail withdrew us years ago. We've been on the run ever since. Then we found out that steam was going to be completely abolished in a few months' time. So we knew we had to find somewhere to hide, and fast. Then Ed remembered Mr. Dark and this railway, so we headed south again and stowed away in here.
We'd have told you, Dave, but you know us. If Mr. Dark finds out we're here, he'll probably send us away again, or worse, make us do some work.
Don't tell him, please!
Alright guys, I won't say anything. But I think you owe Hannah an apology for scaring her.
Do we?
I thought we already apologised.
Well, no, you haven't. Yeah, Ed, apologise to the lady.
Fine, I'm sorry I scared you.
That's alright. I'm just glad that there really wasn't a ghost attacking me earlier.
The five engines laughed at this, whilst the Dark Railway engine quickly promised to try and protect Ed and Sid from being found out by the other engines and Mr. Dark. Bading them farewell, Dave, Hannah and Abomination left Ed and Sid in peace, all the while laughing for thinking that Ed was a ghost.